When criminals in this world appear and break the laws that they should fear and frighten all who see or hear, the cry goes up both far and near for Underdog!
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 Underdog! Speed of lightning!
According to the Royal Scrapbook of Bongo Congo, it was in the year 1752 that the last furious battle raged between the kingdoms of Bongo Congo and Coco Loco. In those troubled times, the king of Bongo Congo was none other than Leonard Lyon, the famous colonist king. Seeing the battle turn against Bongo Congo, King Leonard feared for his country's gold and silver. Secretly, he hid the treasure and made his entry on his famous column. What well-known king hid what great treasure where? The following day, King Leonard Lyon was lost in battle. It was the single clue from his column which, long after battle had ceased, led treasure seekers everywhere to search for the missing gold and silver. But the treasure was never found. Now, more than 200 years later, a curious scene occurred in the secret hideout of those two callous criminals, Biggy Rat and Itchy Brother.
Gee, Big, dig this crazy poem. It's titled, Ode to a Treasure. Only the words are for the birds.
Ah, looks like cold. Where'd you get this book?
I, lifted it out of the library, Big.
What library, bookworm?
The Royal Library, when I was just a tiny tad of a tot.
The Royal Library? And it says property of King Leonard. This may be the clue to the missing treasure of Bongo Congo. We've got to decode the ode.
How?
With the Royal Odie decoder, that's how. We've got to get the decoder from Odie. Then we'll decode the ode, locate the hidden treasure, and be rich forever.
Sure, Big. Let's hit the roadie for Odie.
When they reached the palace, Biggie carefully explained the details of his plan.
You hide behind the bushes, say. I'll wear this disguise and get Cologne to come out with me. All you have to do is smack him with this club.
Okay, Big, I dig.
I represent the Bongo Bugler newspaper. We're doing a little story on the palace. I'd like you to step outside so I can get a picture of you in front of the palace.
Of course, my good man. I shall be delighted.
Right over there, I'll make a real striking pose. That's fine. Now!
Ah, the two treacherous traitors.
Gee, Big, I'm sorry as salt. I just thought this was a better bush for bopping.
Yeah, let me give it a try. Now, this time, no mistake, see? I'll yell fire, and Cologne will come running out of the palace. That's when you jam this bag over him. Got it?
Sure, Big. I'm not, dumb, you know.
Fire! Fire!
Another trick, eh, traitor? Run for your life, or I shall run you through.
I got him, Big! I got him! Man, will Big be, proud as punch when he sees what I got in the bag?
I'm taking no chances this time, see? I'll handle the job.
Yes, this time Biggie Rat made certain he captured the courageous Odie Cologne. Outside the palace, Biggie waited until Odie Cologne left on an errand for town. Then, quickly, the unconscious servant of the king was taken to the hideout of Biggie and Itchy.
Okay, wise guy. That ought to hold you.
Whatever plot you villains are plotting will surely turn against you.
But Odie's words had not stopped the diabolical duo. With the Odie decoder, they quickly decoded the ode written by King Leonard.
I-S-L-A-N Island. That's it. It's decoded.
Ode to a treasure. There's nothing so great as pieces of eight lying under an oak on its island.
So, the treasure's on Oak Island. We're rich, Itch.
Yeah, man. Let's, like, make a dash for the cash. Yeah, we'll, like, sail a bounty main to find our fortune. Yo-ho-ho, at a game of rummy. Rub-a-dub-dub, pull a plug in the tub. 16 men.
Clam up and let's go. We've got some sailing to do, see?
Will these two villains find the long-lost treasure? Will Odie Cologne be able to stop them? And where is King Leonardo? We'll find out in our next exciting episode, Two Beneath the Mask.
Come on and see, Tennessee Tuxedo.
D-D-D.
Tennessee Tuxedo.
We will be parachuting for your pleasure. Sailing seas in search of treasure. Anything so he can measure up to men.
That's Tennessee Tuxedo.
A small penguin.
Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you. We wish you Merry Christmas the whole season through. We hope wreaths of holly and bright mistletoe will make you feel jolly wherever you go. We hope you hear singing a gay Christmas song and sleigh bells are ringing all season
long. Mr. Livingston wants to see you and Chumley right away.
What about Chumley? Can't you see we're busy caroling?
He wants to see you about the Christmas tree.
Oh boy, Chumley, Stanley wants to see us about decorating the Christmas tree. Come on. All right, Stanley. Chumley and I are at your service. We've come to decorate the tree. Now, where is...
Not on your life. You are not going to decorate that tree. I've hired professional decorators to come in and do the job. This is important. The mayor is giving a prize for the best tree in the city, and we are going to win it.
Then what do you want us to do?
I have to go meet the mayor and his wife and bring them back. Now, you wait here and show the decorators where the tree is.
Where is it?
It's outside the auditorium, and the ornaments and everything are inside. You show the decorators where to go, and I'll be back this afternoon.
But, Stanley, we can decorate that tree. We...
No. This is too important. I'm paying to have it done right.
All right, Chumley. Let's get over to the auditorium and start decorating that tree.
But Mr. Livingston said...
I know it, Chumley, but it's Christmas time. A time for joyful giving. We'll trim that tree for Stanley as a Christmas present from us. Well, here's the tree. Let's get it inside. I'll take this end. Come on. All right, let's cut the comedy. We've got a job to do. Come on. In it goes.
You won't fit, Tennessee.
Well, chop those big branches off.
Okay, Tennessee. Pull.
All right, we've got it in here. Now let's stand it up.
Gee, Tennessee, it won't fit.
Well, we'll just have to cut some off. Hand me that saw. There. Now it will fit.
Yeah, but it looks like a dust mop.
I'll cut a little off the handle. There.
It's kind of flat on top and bulgy in the middle. Shouldn't it have kind of a pointy top?
Nothing to it, Chumley. Hand me those clippers. There. Ever see a more beautifully shaped tree?
No, but I've seen bigger ones.
What's going on? This place looks like a lumber camp. That's a Christmas tree?
Gee, Tennessee, that looks awful small. It wouldn't even hold two of Mr. Livingston's ornaments. Oh, he's going to be mad. He's going to be really mad.
All right, so I made a little mistake. But Tennessee Tuxedo will not fail. We'll go out into the woods and cut another one. All right, men. There it is, all ready to trim. Yak, you open all the boxes of ornaments. Baldy, you get the lights ready. Chumley, you steady the ladder. I'll start trimming at the top. Okay, Yak, toss me a red one. Missed. Try again.
Here, Tennessee, I'll hand it to you.
Ah, beautiful. Let me down and admire the effect.
Oh, Tennessee, I...
Perfect.
Tennessee,
magnificent.
You've broken half the ornaments.
Well, accidents will happen. Where are the lights? The lights.
Right here, almost ready to be.
Look at this, there's one missing right here! There she is, all finished. What do you think of her?
Looks a little bare to me.
What it needs is this star right on top.
Be careful.
Look out!
Gee, Tennessee, now you've broken all the ornaments.
Mr. Livingston's going to be awful mad.
Especially when he comes here with the mayor and his wife.
Guess it's time to go see Mr. Whoopi. Maybe he can show us how to make ornaments. And so you see, Mr. Whoopi, we're in kind of a tough spot. Say, that's a beautiful tree you've got there.
Thank you, my boy. Made all the decorations myself.
Gee.
Would you show us how? Boy, if we could only get a tree like that.
But you can. You can make all kinds of beautiful decorations just with things you have around the zoo. And besides, it's fun. Look what you can do with the top of a tin can. Besides, throw it away. Take a pair of dull scissors and cut around the edge like this. Bend some sections up, some down, and whoopee! A beautiful shiny ornament. Here's another. Take colored paper, cut it into a circle, then starting at the edge, cut a spiral into the center. Then you can hang it up so.
Gee, that's great!
Here's an idea with popcorn and cranberries. Take a needle and long thread, push it through a piece of popcorn, then through a cranberry, then through popcorn, then another cranberry, and so on until you have a beautiful long chain to drape on the tree. You can cut stars out of colored paper and angels and Santa Claus. Make little paper baskets out of paper and fill them with candy and hang them on the tree. And cookies! Cookies of all shapes and sizes, all sparkly with sugar and lollipops and shiny paper. Make great ornaments, and then you can eat them. Why, there's no end to the decorations you can make with a little imagination. And whoopee! You'll have that tree trimmed in no time.
Phineas J. Whoopi, thanks a million. Let's go. We've got to get that tree trimmed before Stanley gets back.
And I know you'll be delighted with our tree. I had special decorators come over to trim it. You Tennessee Tuxedo, what have you done?
Greetings, Stanley, and Merry Christmas.
But my ornaments, my beautiful ornaments, and... It is a pretty tree, isn't it?
I think it's the prettiest tree I've ever seen. All those wonderful homemade ornaments.
Looks like the zoo gets the prize.
Merry Christmas, Tennessee. Merry Christmas, Chumley, Yak, and Baldy.
Let's all wish everybody a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you. We wish you a Merry Christmas the whole season through.
Merry Christmas to you. We wish you Merry Christmas the whole season through. We hope you'll hear singing a gay Christmas song, and sleigh bells are ringing all season long. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you. We wish you Merry Christmas the whole season through. Merry Christmas.
forest grows a tall, tall tree. Of course, it was a short tree, but it grew. And down at the bottom of that tree, there's a little old box that's really the home of Mr. Wizard the Lizard.
Yes? Who is that?
It's Tooter the Turtle, Mr. Wizard. I got another favor to ask.
Come in, my boy. Well, hello, my boy. How are you today?
I'm a reformed character, Mr. Wizard. That's how I am.
Reformed? How's that?
Well, I'm not going to fool around trying to be something I'm not. No, sirree, I'm going to get myself a job, that's what.
Well, that is good news, Tudor. What is the job, huh? Selling newspapers, maybe? Mowing the grass?
Nope. And that's what I come over to see about. I want to be one of them construction workers on a real tall skyscraper.
Oh, but Tudor, that's no job for you. That's for big men, with iron muscles and nerves of steel.
Oh, please, Mr. Wizard. It's my big chance to make good.
All right, my boy, if you must. But watch your step now. The first thing that the destruction worker must do is report to the foreman.
Tooter Turtle reporting for work, sir.
New man, huh? Okay, but get this. I'm the boss around here, and I don't take mistakes. Now get to work and watch your step.
Now to get up to the top of the building, the good destruction worker takes the utility elevator, which goes very fast.
Top floor, all out.
When you're doing work 50 stories in the air, it's very important to have the perfect balance. And it is the good idea to never look down. But no matter what happens, the experienced worker always holds on to the tools.
Who's the wise guy, huh? Who dropped this wrench? I'll break him in half. New man, huh? Take that.
One of the most important jobs in building the skyscraper is the riveter man. The steel rivets is heated until they is white hot. And then the hot rivets is tossed to the riveter man, who catches them in the bucket. In the bucket!
Put it there, baby. Pitch it in here, kid. Lots of pepper there, boy.
Yow! My back! My shirt! Yow!
Once the rivet is put in the place, the riveter takes the air hammer and pounds the rivet in the hole. This requires the strong muscles to keep the air hammer steady.
Stop, I say! You bumble-headed, butter-fingered baboon! One more mistake, and you're going to get off this building the fast way. You get me?
Once all the steel girders is in place, the pouring of the cement commences. This is very ticklish business, running the heavy wheelbarrow of wet cement along the narrow girders.
Easy, that's it.
Look out! Now what?
8, 9, 10.
I'll smear him. I'll concrete him. Let me at him.
Now, wait up, Mr. Foreman. Mr. Boxer, it was all a mistake.
Yeah, your last mistake.
But I can explain, honestly, if you'll only give me a chance. Help, Mr. Wizard! Please help me quick!
Oh, my. Trissle, trassle, trussle, drum. Time for this one to come home.
Gee, Mr. Wizard. Looks like I made a mess out of things again.
Always, I tell you, Tudor, be just what you is, not what you is not. Folks, what you is, has the happiest lot.
Go to Bongo Congo, meet the ruling king.
you. Do the bongo congo, first you form a line. Rocking to the rhythm, makes you feel so fine. Now you form a circle, take a turn inside. You find bongo congo, like a circus ride.
In our last episode, Biggy, Rad, and Itchy Brother had located an important clue to the whereabouts of the long-lost gold of Bongo Congo. The clue is a poem in an old book from the Royal Library, a poem titled Ode to a Treasure.
We've got to decode the ode.
And that meant they must get the Royal Odie Decoder. Quickly, the two traders developed plans for capturing True Blue Odie Cologne, keeper of the Odie Decoder. After one failure, and then another, the diabolical duo finally managed to capture Odie Cologne. With Odie safely tied up, Biggy and Itchy quickly decoded the ode.
So, the treasure's buried on Oak Island. We're rich, Itch.
So it was that Biggy and Itchy made off with a pirate ship and headed for Oak Island.
A-sailing over the water, baby.
Okay, Itch, cut the singing and forget the lookout. We got nobody to worry about.
But Biggy had failed to reckon with the skill and cunning of True Blue Odie Cologne. Swiftly biting through the ropes that held him, Odie soon gained his freedom.
Now to take care of those two traitors. I must hurry and tell my king.
What's that? The lost gold of Bongo Congo? And Biggy and Itchy are on their way to get it? Why, that's the most unheard of thing I ever heard of.
But true, sire. There's not a moment to lose.
Of course, I'll hurry into my yachting clothes.
By the time King Leonardo and Odie Cologne were aboard the royal yacht, Biggy and Itchy had already reached Oak Island, and once there, quickly located the giant oak tree from which the island took its name.
Okay, Shovelhead, dig.
But gee, Big, I don't dig. Okay, Big, I dig.
Faster.
In only a few moments, Itchy Brother had uncovered the long-lost treasure of Bongo Congo. Meanwhile, what of King Leonardo and True Blue Odie Cologne?
Confound it, I can't see a thing. The trees are blocking my view.
Beg pardon, sire. But you're looking at the mast.
Oh, yes, of course. Well, let's see now. There they are. They're putting the treasure on board. Now they're hoisting the anchor.
All right, Edge, haul up the anchor.
This is like simple as Simon. Just twisted a wrist.
Well, they've had some trouble, but the anchor's up now. They're sailing this way.
Very well, my king. We shall be ready for them. The cannon is loaded, sire.
Good, good. Here they come. Ahoy there, traitors! Surrender the royal treasure or we'll blast you out of the water.
Uh-oh. That's what you think, royal brother of mine. We have, not yet begun our flight.
The word is fight, loudmouth, not flight.
For me, the word is flight. I'm cutting out of here, Big.
Now maybe you'll get on that cannon. Hurry it up.
The other way! Point the cannon the other way!
In a moment, cannonballs were flying back and forth at a furious rate. As the battle continued, it appeared that Biggy and Itchy were scoring more hits than King Leonardo and Odie Cologne.
Confound it, Odie, you're missing them. You're not aiming high enough. Here, give me the cannon.
But your majesty, you're pointing it too high. Oh no, sire. You're pointing it at our mast. Wait. Duck, sire, the mast is falling. Look, your majesty. Look. Traitors are pinned down by our fallen mast. Oh, you are truly a genius, my king.
Soon, King Leonardo and Odie Cologne were sailing back to Bongo Congo with a long-lost treasure and two unhappy prisoners.
I'm not through yet, wise guys. I've got a plan, son.
What does Biggy Rat mean? What new danger does he have in store for King Leonardo? Will Biggy get free to put his plan into action? Don't miss the next exciting episode of The King and Odie.
Oh,
Tooter.